Damn, let's see. Yeah, I got it on Steam, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I did. Saying don't get it. Okay. Everyone's saying not to do it. Oh, Jesus Christ, that music came in out of nowhere. Welcome back.
Open the door. What if we... One was enough now. We should have stayed clean. I do not trust.
I'm hope... If it can't choose the outfits again, oh well. Oh well, I can't.
What the fuck is happening?
The only thing you miss is an hour. We just entered the second timeline for double exposure. And we're gonna find out what the other timeline offers.
Did I actually manage to rewind time?
Back. Are you okay? It kind of seems like you're on drugs.
Huh?
Period.
Oh.
Hang on. Let me take this jacket off. I wish.
If I had drugs, don't you think I'd share?
How about a mom?
I'd share.
You want to get blasted with your favorite photographer?
You want to get blasted with your favorite photographer?
You act like I was born into this world old. I had my wild years.
Sorry, what were we talking about? Somebody mentioned a phone call?
Yes. I was shocked too. I didn't know people still answered their phones.
Funny, Mom. And yeah, it wasn't a big deal. It was just from the publisher.
Right! Your book! The secret book!
Well, now...
I'm so proud of my girl. Publishing is always such a difficult endeavor.
Thanks, Mom.
No one going to take our order?
It's been like a few minutes. Have you ever had a food service job? Like, ever?
I can go ask what the holdup is, Yasmin. No sweat.
See? That is so thoughtful of you, Maxine. No need. The whole place could use a facelift, to be honest.
Tell me it's not Amanda. It's not Amanda.
Come on, Yasmin. You don't
it's
have
Amanda.
Else to be.
Amanda
I
died,
need to
bro.
Ask Sophie about God. Where do I even start? What is that?
Oh, here we go again.
Oh shit. Dude, your nose.
It's fine. Just a nosebleed. Back in a sec.
Okay, so it's not Amanda. Amanda's still alive.
Right. Right, of course. There's a snapping turtle, so there's an Amanda.
Wow. I thought you got lost in a blizzard. Dropped your phone down a bottomless pit. Something.
Lost?
No. You're right, I'm being passive aggressive. Sorry. It's just... You asked me out and then ignored my text for 48 hours. Kinda sucked, is all.
Oh, so...
Okay, so it's been
so
2 days.
I asked you out.
It's been 2 days.
I mean, that's how I interpreted it when you stood there 2 nights ago and said you wanted to go on a date.
2 nights ago is exactly when I asked Amanda out. So, I haven't gone back in time. Oh shit! This Amanda never talked to me about slowing down our relationship. Because Sophie isn't dead.
So, are you gonna tell me what happened?
I drank, like, way too much the other night. I've been in kind of a state.
For 2 days? Were you kids mixing liquor and paint thinner?
Didn't mean to make you feel like crap.
Hey. Shit happens. I won't bug you about it. Just didn't love it.
Come on, we gonna get in our bag.
Take it easy, eh?
Take it easy, eh?
So if I didn't rewind, this is some kind of alternate reality. But I still talked to Amanda 2 days ago. So far, everything here seems basically the same, except... I was hoping my nosebleed days were behind. I still can't believe Sophie is here, alive, having lunch with Yasmin as if everything is normal. As if I didn't see her die 2 days ago. In case this does all go sideways. It was supposed to be a candid.
You'll never catch me alive.
Oh, God.
Oh, Sophia, come now.
I swear, one day I'll get a candid of Sophie. They can entertain each other. They've had years of practice.
Alright. What are we missing?
I guess Krampus isn't canceled in this universe. Is all of this for that Krampus party? Who's performing?
It's for the Krampus roast.
Krampus roast?
Oh man, is this your first time? Yeah, Krampus on campus is,
interesting.
Yeah.
It would kind of suck to appreciate or live all of this,
hell
not
yeah,
share
Diamond.
With anyone.
Way to go. Nice to see this place gearing up for Christmas. Aw, this truly fills me with the holiday spirit.
I want to work at the turtle. The fuck? This shit looks sick.
Jesus Christ. Every time I look at that thing, it's like a fresh jump scare. What a calamity.
It's shouter time.
gender-neutral bathrooms. We love to see it. Holy shit. I'm back, aren't I? In Dead World. This is so fucking crazy.
What the fuck? The current timeline is displayed for an unlimited amount of time after shifting or after recalling your current objective. Don't think I'll forget you trying to embarrass me in front of Dr. Hunter anytime soon, Miss Caulfield. Thanks for taking a minute to talk with me in the fab earlier. I needed that. There's something else, but probably best not to say it over text. Equal to meet up later. Of course.
My gut tells me it's not good news. Because why would it be?
Appreciate you taking care of my package. It could be temperamental in the wrong hands. Safi, I think we should talk. To text me? Sorry, that thing's got a mind of its own. Are you thinking about Safi again?
How could Vin mix me up?
What the fuck?
It's just so sad.
I didn't even... Another Polaroid from our mystery photographer.
No, Tony, I love it. I do. It's as thoughtful as ever. No, no buts.
I hate that they canceled Krampus for
I know you did, Stu. You sent me a
Jesus
gift.
Jesus Christ,
you won't be coming this year either. Krampus isn't unsettling. It's fun. But honestly, I wanted you to finally meet Safi and Max. You love them. Right. Next year for sure. And thank you again for the gift. I mean it. I'll be back, babe.
Whoa. Am I? Oh no. I hope Amanda didn't spend all her soup energy on cooking for me. Oh shit, this is the Amanda I talked to this morning?
Max, you're here.
I'm here. Surprise.
You good?
I'm okay. You really cheered me up earlier.
Happy to lend out my comedic stylings to girls in need.
Period.
Thanks.
Are you here for?
We already talked in her office. She seems to be doing, you know, bad.
God knows. I offered her free coffee for as long as she wants it. You gotta get back to it. Don't forget I'm here for you, okay?
Thanks, Amanda.
Damn. Okay. So far, no reason to leave the other timeline.
If I can't get on here, I will face God and walk backwards into hell.
Oh, I'm a computer. Can I crash at your place tonight? You're looking good today. Want snacks? Right. You must be topping the charts because you're the hottest single this week. Sheesh.
No Christmas decorations on this side.
Oh, hi, Miss Caulfield. I'm sorry for your loss.
Huh?
You were close to Safi, right?
Oh, yeah. Thanks. I appreciate it. Hi, Yasmin.
Oh, Maxine. You're here. I'd invite you to sit down, but...
I understand. I didn't expect to see you here.
When we spoke this morning, I wasn't planning on coming. But I couldn't help habit. Safi and I used to have lunch here every week. Terrible food. But it's close. Anyhow, take care. I'm sorry, Maxine. I'm all tapped out.
Alright, so we're... we're good on the dead side. I don't see anything else to interact with.
Okay, so I can cross back and forth. That's good to know. Safi and Yasmin are probably wondering where I am. I...
honestly, Safiya, I wish you'd have told me sooner. I was getting around to it.
All clear? We don't need to get you a blood transfusion?
Oh, I'm golden. Probably just the weather, you know?
Oh, did the forecast call for massive nosebleeds?
Right.
Duty calls. Send me the bill for the windshield, please, Safiya.
Windshield?
Another piece of shit pie. Someone... hold on, it's easier if I just show you.
Jesus. Fuck, Safi. Is that your car?
Charming, right? Found it this morning.
Do you have any idea who did it?
No. But if I ever find out, it's on site.
Hey.
They couldn't have picked a fight with the Volvo instead.
This is gonna sound bananas, but I feel like I've met this cow.
You have. It's from right over there. Whatever, I gotta meet the tow truck.
Wait. Hold on. The broken horn. Looks like there was something written on it.
Max, you know I adore you, but read the room, bud. I'm not really in the mood to stare at photos of my fucked up car all day.
Yeah, sorry.
Huh.
It's okay, Rocky. She's gone. Oh, tell me my proposal was shitty, isn't it?
Hold up. Safi's alive in this world. Her car probably didn't get trashed in the other, right? Oofa doofa. That's gonna take some getting used to. No Christmas decorations on this side. There she is, safe and sound. Fuck. Size does matter. I'm going to have to find a way to get up there. I'm pretty sure I just saw a stepladder. Where was that?
Stepladder?
That should help me reach the cow skull.
Hang on, it looks like I can ponder outside. What?
So he comes out to get the bathroom key, and we shoot him?
What?
Doing good so far. Then, and nothing. Then he's crater just focuses me for now.
What?
Oh, shit. This must be that big assassin game all the undergrads play. They're using the bathroom key as bait. Doubt they'll just give that up. Where else could I get a replacement key?
Bathroom key.
That's the way back across.
Shit. Do we really need to lure him outside?
It's way too cold to be out here, but I'm pretty sure.
Hey, do you have the bathroom key?
Yeah?
Could I grab that from you?
We're using it. We'll put it back when we're done.
You're using it?
Yup.
Alright. So I have to find the bathroom key and then up in the other world.
Campus activities when you were in school?
You know all about my college days, Safia.
Yeah, I know about your GPA. The drugs you took.
There it is. What's in the bathroom?
Is that a signature?
Oh, Lucas.
Ugh, this is so stylized, I can barely read it. Lucas Colmenero. Oh, shit. Did Lucas smash Sophie's windshield? He's a dick, but I don't know if he's a property damage level dick. But why would anyone else bother snapping his name off? Weird. This is weird. I wonder if anyone at the Snapping Turtle saw the whole thing go down.
New message from Diamond. If you've heard from Moses, he's been closed off the past day or so. I'm worried about him. The bathroom key for
gender neutral bathrooms. We love to see it.
I don't know what I need the bathroom key for, but all right.
Tim, the key's back. Hank, fuck.
You're welcome, dude.
Oh, it was just a random fucking side quest? Help timid guy get to the bathroom. I wonder if this person's available for talking now. No? Okay. Let's go fuck myself.
Hey, Amanda. I have kind of a weird question.
Do you ever have non-weird questions?
Occasionally. On a leap year.
The whole year or just February 29th?
Right.
Now who's asking weird questions?
Right.
All right, hit me then. What's the question?
Have you had any skulls go missing lately?
Wow. That's an extremely specific question. And I can't believe the answer is yes. Our only skull, in fact. I'm dying to know why you ask.
Because it somehow ended up in Sophie's windshield.
Wait, what the fuck? Are you serious?
Yeah, I'm trying to unravel the mystery.
Jesus. A skull? I mean, have they never heard of a brick?
Literally. When did you notice your cow got rustled?
Literally just this morning, before I clocked in. It had to be sometime last night.
Did you know it had Lucas's name on it?
Who? Oh, Colmenero. That makes sense. He's the one who donated it.
Seriously? Why a cow skull?
I have no idea. I'm like physically incapable of listening to that dude when he talks.
That part.
Did you see him in here last night?
Lucas? I don't think so. Why? You think he broke into the turtle to, what, steal back his cow skull?
I didn't say it was a good theory. Did you see anything suspicious?
I mean, the Abraxas kids are perpetually suspicious. They took up like 6 tables last night. Maybe one of them saw something. Hell, maybe one of them stole it.
Thanks. I appreciate the info.
Nancy Drew.
Fuck, I need to think. What is going on?
Notes. There's notes on people? Hey, that's me. What the fuck? Okay. Snapping turtle bartender, comedian, live music enjoyer. I have a big stupid crush. Someone checked a cow skull through Sophie's car window. Who would do that and why? Amanda says a cow skull belongs to Lucas and that he donated it to the snapping turtle. Why would he donate a cow skull? Amanda says that the Abraxas kids might know something since they were there the night the cow skull went missing. Film student Moses' TA, Junior Abraxan, comes to my seminars. Gwen, creative nonfiction professor, Sophie's mentor, author of If the Highway Should Take Me as Its Wife. Loretta, journalism student, sophomore, occasionally comes to my seminars, true crime podcaster, blackmailer, annoying, avoid. Lucas, professor, department chair, literature, best-selling author of Wilder Beasts Than These, real humble about it too. Someone checked a cow skull through Sophie's car window, could have been Lucas. Moses said Sophie hated Lucas's guts. If there was bad blood there, maybe Lucas took it out on her car. Missing horn was signed by Lucas. Amanda says Bessie belongs to Lucas and that he donated it to the snapping turtle. Why would he donate a cow skull? Moses, grad student, astrophysicist, Sophie's best friend, my acquaintance? Moses and Sophie have been best friends for years. Inside jokes, silly traditions, the works. Moses is used to Sophie being secretive. Apparently, that's as normal for her as it is for me. Moses said Sophie hated Lucas's guts. I'll keep an eye on him. That night, Moses and I found Sophie's body that night. He called 911. We were questioned for hours. We started talking to each other about her. We're going to get through this together. Reggie, econ student, Junior Abraxan, frequent attender of my seminars. Sophie, grad student, poetry major, my best friend, dead in one world, alive in another. Sophie has a book deal for her poetry, and she's so excited about what it means for her. Sophie and Yasmin seem so proud of Sophie's book. deal. It's good to see them getting along. Vin is Yasmin's administrative assistant, president of Abraxas. Someone threw a cow skull through Safi's windshield. The Abraxas kids might have taken it from the snapping turtle, and they report to Vin. Vin runs Abraxas. He might have had his goons steal the cow skull. Yasmin is president of Kaladin University, Safi's mom. Okay. That we knew. Alright, update. December 6th. This little shit Loretta thinks she's Geraldo. What college student goes to this length to get a scoop? I still don't know what's up with Gwen, and she probably hates me. And what does she mean, one snoop to another? I snoop for good. Gwen was still acting shady as hell. There could be something there. Not the drawing. Thanks for making a poor bone weary bartender's night. Just trying out this new number somebody gave me. Also, good morning. I get it. Morning. Mornings are for suckers. You didn't have to say it back. I'm just stoked about our date. Cool guess. You're busy, so hit me up when you can. Just got to the North Quad, usual spot. See you in a minute or two. So it's not exactly the warmest of December days. Let me know if you're running late. I don't mind personally, but you know how my mom is about tardiness. If you can't make it, that's fine. The day I get a candidate of Sophia will be my crowning achievement. Huh.
What if it's not just a prank? What if this Sophie is in danger too? I just got her back.
To me,
at least I know where to start. Lucas Colmenero and the Abraxas Society.
I guess it wouldn't make sense to reintroduce Chloe, but the reason why I was like, oh, it could be Chloe is because of the cow skulls. Used to be like a t-shirt, used to be a thing in the first one, but...
Find the skull rustler. Save Safi, hopefully. And my best leads are Lucas Colmenero and the Abraxas Society. Vin's the head honcho of Abraxas. I could start with him. Maybe I should do a little digging into Gwyn Hunter, too. She was acting pretty odd earlier. Time to start asking questions. Whoever fucked with Sophie's car isn't just gonna out themselves.
And, don't get cute, either. You find it, you bring it right back to me.
Right.
Well, go! Find it! Undergrads, am I right?
Can't live with them, can't run a shadowy secret society without them.
Right.
You ever want to borrow one, just let me know. No one should be without a lackey, Max.
And yet, I've made it this far somehow. You lose something?
Mostly my patience.
Okay. Hey, I...
Yeah. Cute banter, barely restrained sexual tension, etc. Right. I'm busy, Max. Another time.
That's right.
Okay. What does Vin have them looking for? Let's say I find your missing patience.
Then I wouldn't be busy anymore, would I?
Right. Sassy much?
If some hot chips don't get you an A, I don't know what will. the snapping turtle looking for volunteers at the Lakeport Soup Kitchen? Amanda really is the best.
Damn.
That person's skating on thin ice. And I can't believe I don't even mean that metaphorically.
Right.
Metalworking is kind of like photography. You never know quite how the environment will shape your work.
True. That's real as fuck.
Safi told me the campus would be gorgeous for the holidays. Glad I actually get to see that here. That's my handwriting. Wait. Am I the mystery photographer?
Score! Diamond a gazillion points. Reggie zero.
I thought we said no more ambushes.
Stop whining. You're fine.
Good cop, bad cop is going to be the way to... Oh.
You know, if you want to ask Diamond out, I can introduce you. I'm 70% sure she doesn't bite.
Right.
How about I put in a good word and
Vince
tell me was
Vince
really
isn't. Distracted.
Whatever good he dogs. Lost must be important.
There has to be some way I can hear what they're saying without them catching me.
Oh. Where's, there it is.
Vin's lackeys.
Facial recognition. I'm not sure. But if the passcode, Diamond can probably find a way into it. Good point.
Holy shit. Someone took Vin's phone? And they think it was Diamond. I can use this.
Oh yeah, where did Diamond go, though?
Come on.
Right.
I don't get it. Diamond is in Abraxas too. Why would Vin's goons think...
Men, what's stopping you from dressing like this?
Where is she?
Nothing like a fun mystery to get you out of bed, huh, guys?
Art student prank or horrifying creature, the world may never know. So, how do you keep things fresh after literal decades of passionate embracing? So, if you're wondering why those Abraxas kids are eyeballing you,
it's because someone stole Finn's phone.
Seriously? They think it was me? The clownery!
Oh my god.
Of course they do. Of course.
I take it I was right to assume they're full of shit.
Always a safe assumption. But if you find out who did it, tell them I owe them a drink.
Period.
You don't exactly strike me as the typical, Abraxan.
In the Vin Lang mold? God, no. But the org itself has potential. If we could just get him away from it.
Right.
You ever think about being, I don't know, Abraxas' boss? Queen. High priest.
President. I would love to.
So, are you and Vin rivals? Enemies?
To hear him tell it? Both.
And to hear you tell it?
Vin is one of those yappy little purse dogs who swears he's a pit.
Right. Damn.
Okay. Cool. Thanks, Diamond.
And hey, if you talk to Vin again, tell him the only thing I'm taking from him is his crown.
Right.
So, bad news, I'm not sure who took your phone. Good news, it wasn't Diamond.
Holy shit. You figured all that out with, like, zero clues.
I just knew who to ask. And how. So, about my question.
I'm free Tuesday after 7. And I'm partial to a Japanese single malt.
That's whiskey?
Right, yes. But damn, do I have so much to teach you. So your place or mine?
Sounds like a profoundly underwhelming evening.
Don't knock it till you've tried
Oof.
It.
So, someone fucked up Sophie's car. They didn't take anything, but they used a cow skull to do it.
Jesus. Max, that's crazy. Is she okay?
She's fine. Who would do something like that, though?
You mean who in Abraxas would?
I didn't say that.
No. But it's what you meant, isn't it? Many times some nonsense happens on campus. People trip over themselves accusing Abraxas. Vandalism, destruction of property, that's beneath us, Max. We're performers.
The audience wasn't impressed.
That's how you know it wasn't us.
Right.
Besides, how do you even get a cow skull through a windshield?
Hold on. I didn't say anything about our windshield. Wild, right?
I'd love to keep chatting and freezing my balls off, but I've got a phone to find.
And if
right.
I need to reach you?
I'll end up in my office eventually.
Ben, what did you do?
Sussy sus.
Glad my other suspects had the sense to stay indoors.
All right. Let's go find out.
I can probably find Gwen in her office. And I think Lucas has a habit of working over by the cafe.
You cool? Okay. I want an...
Max.
Right.
Sorry. Busy, busy. Need something?
Actually, I...
Catherine. I've been waiting for an hour. No, just put Robbie on. Oh, sure. I'm only the boy's father. Who fucking cares, right? How can you say...
Whoa. Adds a whole new meaning to nuclear family.
Right.
If Lucas has it out for Sophie, there might be something incriminating in that case. Is that an email? Dated December 5th. That's when Sophie's car was vandalized. I need to get in that briefcase. Instant lock opening powers would be great. In the meantime, I have to find that key.
Going to the Nationals. You're great. Robbie, I got a split. Uh-huh. I love you too, buddy.
Weird. This yep. Lucas seems to be on great terms with his family.
Hey.
Right.
Bye.
Lucas.
Max. Can't imagine it would be much fun to assassinate my character without an audience.
No, I meant what I said.
I wasn't going to stand by while you used Sophie to pump yourself up.
Wow. I never had a chance with you, did I? Not with Sophie in your ear.
She never really mentioned you.
Yep.
I find that hard to believe.
This guy's so pretentious.
That's a lot of books.
A lot of my book. Signed copies for the Burlington Book Expo. They invited me to deliver the keynote this year. Have you seen the standee they put up with me?
Can't say I have.
Huh. Yeah, I might have to reposition it then. The standards for the expo really declined over the years. We've had a lot of mediocre
visitors. Yikes, this dude can talk.
It's a shame.
How am I gonna get that key?
Years and years and years, people still love the characters.
Oh, crap. I forgot. What time is it? I have to go give something to Moses, before his class. Good luck with the book expo.
I'll knock down the cutout and he'll put it back up.
I bet Lucas would really hate if something happened to this. Now, what can I use to do some permanent damage? Dare I channel my inner Chloe?
Fuck yeah.
Now, how exactly do I want to get under Lucas's skin?
Yeah.
The classics are classics for a reason.
Yep.
Oh my goodness! Who would do a thing like this? Someone should tell Lucas right away.
She returns. I take it you've delivered your something to Moses?
My something? Right, my something. Yep, something delivered. So, not to be the bearer of bad news, but... somebody drew horns and a tail on your book expo standee.
Are you serious? I just put that... Come on!
Some people just have no respect for other people's property.
Love to hate this guy.
Come on.
His notes are great. No wonder his classes are always full.
Simpler words are often more effective. Excellent description that could be elevated. More active language. The paradox of greed and success in our mutual friend. Once again, too passive. Convince me with every tool available to you that your words are true.
His notes are great. Lucas's famous book.
Interesting.
So that explains the cow skull and the snapping turtle. But does that mean he's the one who smashed Sophie's windshield?
Oh. Parking ticket.
$67?
Ouch.
That damn cow skull again. Who threw this fucking thing?
The startlingly prescient novel, Lucas Colmenero is one of our generation's most exciting new voices.
Did Lucas go to a gun range? Does Lucas have a gun? Lucas was with his agent last night, not the snapping turtle. He couldn't have vandalized Sophie's car. So, who did?
The small potatoes are not your dinosaur. It's been ages since your first book. You need as much publicity as you can get. Let's meet up tonight to talk strategy, Hall of Fame Tavern at 8 p.m. I've circled where you could park so you don't get a ticket again. Underpaid author wrangler.
No point in looking through Lucas's stuff now. Satisfying though it is. Yeah, not you, Lucas. Seriously. So this is how the literati spend their free time. Lucas is an AA? Good for him. Guess this Lucas didn't get a chance to put this up yet. Sophie?
Temporary restraining order. Protected person is Lucas Colmenero. Protected person's minor children, Roberto Colmenero Jr. Restrained person is Sophie. Colleagues. On more than one occasion, the restrained person purposefully did one or more of the following to the protected person: followed, monitored, surveilled, threatened, or made threats, interfered with property.
Is Lucas really trying to file a restraining order against Sophie? Does she know about this? I'd better show her.
Max? What are you...
Lucas, this isn't...
You can't tell her.
What?
You can't send Sophie that photo. Let me explain. Please.
Alright, to your side.
Catherine, my ex-wife, she called last night, mad as hell, because Robbie, our son, was repeating back to her things I supposedly told him. But I never... I mean, I could never... The shit Robbie says I told him, it makes me sick to think about.
Maybe he was making it up? Acting out for attention?
No. No. Even if Robbie was the type, this shit, I mean... Where would a kid even get ideas like that?
Huh.
He told her, I said he was the reason for the divorce. Okay. And somehow that was the least fucked up thing I'm purported to have said.
This still doesn't explain the reason.
It's not that bad.
I wasn't even there that night, Max. But someone said those things to my son.
And you think it was Safi?
Listen. Safi once threatened to turn Robbie against me. I know she's capable of it.
Wait. Why would Robbie trust Safi? Does he even know her?
She used to babysit for us, believe it or not. Robbie adored her.
And none of this has anything to do with what happened to Safi's car?
Something happened to her car?
Never mind. Forget it.
Look. I know she's your friend. I know you have no reason to believe me over her, but just give me a chance to get this shit in order first, without her interfering. I just want to make sure my boy never has to hear anything like that again.
This could all be a lie. One big smear campaign against Safi. But, oh, what if it's not?
Damn. It sucks because, like, obviously, I don't give a shit about this guy at all. And so, like, I'm like, but I also kind of believe him, low-key. So I'm like, like, I believe you. I believe him.
Okay, I deleted it. This is between you and her. None of my beeswax.
Thank you. If I can't find any evidence to back this up, I don't even know. At least I have time to look.
I think I've wrung all I can out of Lucas today.
You give me a second? Surely another minute and a half isn't going to taint the building with my presence.
Just leave everything behind, Professor. You won't need any university materials.
Yeah, but I do need my car keys if you want me to leave the campus, don't I? Think.
You're not to return to Caledon property before the hearing, under penalty of law.
I know how this works. You don't need to read me my rights.
Just doing my job, Professor.
That'll go over great in Nuremberg. This is crazy. This is fucking crazy. I told Yasmin already that none of it's true. She knows it's fucking bullshit.
Wow.
This is all just
some kind of crazy
mix-up. I guess something
screwy is going down here, too. But at least... Yeesh. I wonder what that was about. This looks like one hell of an art final.
Damn.
I should check it out. Damn. I didn't know a phone booth could feel like a personal attack.
Every semester, Art 450 interactive installation students vote on one another's final projects. The winner's project is displayed in the fab. Dual tone, past and present, is this semester's top pick, Professor Sullivan. By Diamond, Washington. Have you ever wanted to send your future self a message or get a message from someone in the past reminding you what your life was like 2, 5, 10 years ago? Past and present lets you do that. Step into the booth marked past, pick up the phone and leave a message for someone to receive in the future booth, or choose the future and hear a message someone, maybe even you, recorded in the past. Future messages are randomized, so there's no telling how long ago your dispatch from the past is from. That's part of the fun. Enjoy your time-traveling phone calls, Kaladin. Where's the other one?
Pretty sure you need a time machine to even find a phone booth now.
Some things are going to be out of your control, and that's okay. That's life. Let it surprise you.
Oh, and it's on the opposite.
What he's doing is wrong. It always felt like it was, but now I know it's true. I was starting to think my writing just wasn't good enough. How fucked is that? But she stood up for me. Nobody else has ever done that. Ever. So you know what? Fuck that guy. I won't stop writing because he's uncomfortable. That's my message to the future.
Wow. Whatever he was talking about, I hope it worked out. So this Gwen just got escorted out by security. While Dead World Gwen is having hushed phone calls about the police and trying to break into locked bookcases. Time to snoop like I've never snooped before. With the way they hustled Gwen out, I don't think these stick. Whoa, Reggie got an A-.
I saw him before he saw me. He was standing on top of a couch in the Abraxas house living room yelling a monologue, and he had a golden crown in his dark hair. Everyone faced him like he was really a king, and in that moment I thought, I am so fucked. Way to go out on a high note. This is your best writing of the semester. You excel at noticing small details, and I can easily picture the man you're writing about. You're under the word count by 500 words, though. Intro to Nonfiction. I didn't think he would ask me to be his TA for Astronomy 101. I mean, I've never taken an astronomy class in my life, but then he said, I asked you because you could do anything, Diamond. I've never seen you mess up. At first I thought that's not true, but then I thought, wait, if he believes I can do anything, maybe I really can. This is a very good meditation on confidence. You compellingly trace the history of your relationship with your own worth. That said, you still write about yourself with some hesitation, something you don't hear when you speak in class. Ask yourself why that is and keep writing.
Loretta doesn't seem like the type to be happy with a B.
We don't know when the first ever adoption happened. That's because humans have been caring for each other's children since the beginning of recorded history. The word adoption comes to us from Latin and means to take by choice. This is a well-researched piece about social practices of adoption. Good job citing. Good job citing your sources, but this isn't a personal essay because there's nothing personal here. I get the sense you didn't have the time or inclination. You needed to make this piece shine.
You reap what you sow, Loretta. Oh, you're other Loretta, aren't you? Oh well. Almost a full cup of coffee. Gwen must have just sat down to drink it. Oh my god, an answering machine.
Gwen. If you're screening your calls, pick up. I just got an email from Boss Bitch, and the phone is ringing off the hook. What the fuck is happening? Babe, pick up the phone. Just come home, okay? We'll figure this out.
Dr. Hunter? This is David from Intro to Nonfiction. I saw the notice in the lecture hall that your classes are going to be canceled for the rest of the semester, and I just wanted to check up and see if you're all right. I mean, I'm sure you're fine, but I don't know. We're all kind of worried. Okay, bye.
Dr. Hunter, by now, I'm sure you checked your mailbox, and the contents enclosed therein. Please understand, this is a courtesy from one working woman to another. I don't want to hear excuse or lies. I'll have to ask you to leave campus until we get this whole thing sorted out. Good day.
You would never do what, Gwen? What is this about?
From Hunter to Rati Meha? Hi, Rati. There's no good way to say this, but Yasmin put me on unpaid leave pending a disciplinary meeting. I'm not supposed to talk about the details, but if you hear any rumors, please know. Please know I would never do this. I'm not stupid or desperate. I don't know how long I'll be gone, so can you water my plants? Some of these little guys have been thriving for years now, and I'm not letting Kaladin kill them. I'll owe you a drink, Gwen.
Gwen canceled her weekly meetings with Sophie? Why? Gwen's wife. Claudia, I think. I met her at a faculty event last month. Gwen fucking adores her. Damn, talk about a green thumb. I'm going to read this, I swear. If I ever have time for pleasure reading again. I had decided I would hitchhike across the country. If I still wanted to die when I got to the Pacific, then I could do it peacefully. Hell of an opening line, Gwen.
Damn. For real?
Fiction, nonfiction, poetry, plays, bunch of scenes. Is there anything Gwen doesn't read? Live fast, eat ass. Wise words. Whatever they mean. It's like a bumper sticker evolved into a bookend. Between Gwen and me, I bet we've road-tripped most of the country. Caked up Mothman, goated with the sauce. God, why didn't I trade travel stories with Gwen before all this? These emails are from way back. Like, before Sophie knew she wanted to be a poet.
From Sophie to Dr. Gwen. Thank you again for letting me turn in a memoir piece and verse. I'm really into poetry this semester. I might make it my creative writing focus. I have a question, though. What is the note, "Your voice doesn't feel like your own" mean? Thanks. Safi, happy to explain. Your memoir in verse is technically very impressive. Most people sound like broken records when they write villanelles, but the voice feels less like you and more like you're imitating classic poets. Ask yourself, how can you inhabit your own words more comfortably? Cheers. I see, I'll try my best. Gwen, thanks again for being willing to read this. I had to write down what I felt or I'd fucking explode. Do you think there's anything here? Is it weird that I'm already writing about her? The willows are weeping. The fruit is rotting. From the branch, I saw her. Glowing, and I saw her. Go out. I'm sorry. I am so sorry. I am no longer anything else. Hey, Safi, never feel weird for wanting to write about pain or whatever it is that's clogging the pipes in your mind. This poem is raw and honest, and I can tell. My advice is to be more specific and personal with that last line. What does it mean for you to no longer feel anything else?
I knew Gwen mentored Safi, but I didn't realize she was this involved.
Possible homes for Safi's manuscript. Star Shower Books. Thicketwood Publishing. Present Leaf Press. Currently seeking full manuscripts from early career poets. Reminder, connect Safi's agent with Maria at PLP, Arclight Literary or Vermilion Press.
This is the book I got for Gwen. Wait. Gwen is asking questions about Safi's death.
Hey, R, did you see Safi at your poetry group on Friday night or at all over the weekend? If so, did she seem off? Did she mention getting any news? Leave your answers in this book and return it to the library. I don't want everyone to know I'm asking questions. Thanks, I'll owe you forever, DGH. Saw Safi at poetry on Friday and for coffee on Sunday. She seemed fine, seemed happy, didn't mention any news, not that I heard, at least. Is everything okay? This all kind of freaking me out.
Why would Safi have started acting off on Friday? Something must have happened.
Dr. Hunter. Your condolences, you know I do, but I'd prefer if you didn't contact me for a few days. There's a few things I need to get in order. Whatever the case, I'll see you this afternoon. You should get the call to Vin later today. Hey, babe. Just checking in on my favorite workaholic who won't take a single bereavement day. Love you. Take care of yourself, okay? I'll see you tonight.
Hi, Professor Hunter. This is Vin Long from Dr. Fai's office. I'm just calling to confirm an all-hands staff meeting this afternoon in the second floor lounge of the administration building. Attendance is, unfortunately, mandatory. Gwen, I hope you didn't. I'm not sure if you should. I don't know. Just, I wouldn't blame yourself.
Huh. Odd.
Why would Safi have started acting off on Friday? Something must have happened. Gwen is guilty of plant neglect. Although... Drink up, buddy. If Safi was an undergrad, this reading must have been at least, what, 4 years ago? This thing looks older than Caladon. That must have been some call with Maria on Friday. Gwen even planned out a time to follow up. All right, Hacker Max. Let's go. Search sent to Maria. Enter. Wait, this is Safi's publisher. Gwen got Safi's book canceled?
Oh, what? Hello, Gwen. Thank you again for taking the time to talk with me last week. I've discussed the concerns you raised with my senior editor over the weekend. He agrees they're sufficient to merit action. We have begun the process of pulling Safi's project, All the Daughters We Don't Talk About. I know this isn't the outcome any of us exactly wanted, but I really appreciate your insights on the matter. I hope to work with you again soon, Maria. I'm reaching out to follow up on our conversation from Friday. I know I dropped a bit of a bomb on you, but have you had a chance to discuss my concerns with your senior? I appreciate any update you're able to provide.
These emails are from way back. Like, before Safi knew she wanted to be a poet. I knew Gwen mentored. I thought Gwen helped Safi set this all up in the first place.
Huh.
Why would she? No. This all has to add up. Somehow. Hope Vin's back at his desk now. I still have questions for that guy.
I think I did everything in here I could. I kind of get people's complaints about the game, but I personally am not bothered by it. I'm kind of, like, intrigued. Like, okay, like, I'm curious to see what's going on and stuff, but I get the Chloe complaints, and I understand probably, like, the pacing, because the other game's, like, it's slow, but...
Time to follow up with Vin about that windshield.
It gets very dramatic very fast.
Let's see if I can't make this canary sing.
Hey, you found it. Kudos.
Max.
Sorry to startle, just... That was good luck, finding it so fast.
Oh, right. Yeah, I'm such an idiot. I just left it on my desk.
It's been that kind of day.
Yeah.
Did something happen to your phone while it was lost?
Huh? Oh, no, it's fine. I just can't get it unlocked. Fuck. It's gonna lock if I get it wrong again.
Wait. You can't remember your own code?
I am like... extremely hungover. You're lucky I can remember who you are.
You seem fine out on the quad.
I set the code to the year some old fucking magician scientist died. Slipped my mind.
Magician scientist?
Abraxas shit. I must have thought it was cool at the time. Can you just... I don't know. I'm not at my best right now.
Sure. Vin is definitely hiding something. Getting into that cell phone is my best shot at finding out what. Too hungover to remember a passcode? Jeez. Good thing I know another Vin.
But where is a time-changing area? There it is.
doing? I think this is affecting my brain.
Those look like they should be in a file folder somewhere. Jeez. Somebody robbed an airport lounge. If I want to get in that phone, I gotta talk to Dead World Vin first.
Where the fuck is he then?
Pick a card, any card. Or whatever.
Fucking shit. Huh? Oh. Max. It's just you.
Huh? What can I do you for?
What do you mean it's just me?
Well, there are a few people, for instance, who I might hesitate getting workday slosh in front of. You, Miss Caulfield, are not one of them.
Thanks.
Fair.
I'm flattered.
Join me?
How many of those do you have?
Ooh, just don't check the recycling.
Does it smell Safi?
Safi. Everything is about Safi nowadays. This isn't about Safi, Max. This... about you and me.
Right.
Come on. Illicit day drinking with your coworkers is sexy. Be sexy, Max.
I think I'll pass on the sexiness.
Right. Yes. Right.
Hey, Ben? Can I ask for something kind of weird?
I don't do foot stuff.
Right.
Damn.
Right.
Well, there goes my Friday night.
Vin does owe me a favor.
I have a question. Do you know anything about a dead magician scientist?
Jack Parsons? Occultist rocket scientist?
Oh, maybe.
What about him?
Nothing, really. I just...
They killed him, you know. Just like JFK.
Right.
Oh. What, year did that happen?
Hey. Any more questions, and I'll have to charge you.
Right. Of course.
Jack Parsons. Surely this place has a book on him somewhere.
I'm going up there with or without you. I have to see...
Okay.
See what? You talked to one Renekton. What if I told you about...
Okay, Encyclopedia. Do you have a certain... No Jack Parsons here?
Do I have to spell it out for you?
Jack... Pretty sure.
1952. June 17th, 1952.
Is that a therapist's business card? I'll bet some folks on the other side. This must belong to someone flashy and forgetful and cold. She's staring holes into Yasmin's portrait. I wonder why. Not totally sure how to read these, but I don't like the look of that tower card. Looks like Vin takes it back. A Krampus of your very own. That's a lot of canceled meetings. I wonder if it has anything to do with that disciplinary hearing of Gwen's.
Okay, just canceled meeting emails.
Very macabre chic. But I guess that's Ben's brand. Wow, Yasmin wiped out her whole schedule for this disciplinary hearing.
Damn.
Yikes. Aw, what a cute little guy. He won a drama award. Shocker. I hope this is the right code.
Oh, I'm like, I thought it was gonna be a pattern one for a second.
Success.
I was like, the fuck?
I'm sorry, Vin. I know this is a brutal misuse of powers, but I need to know if you had anything to do with this. Food pics, mirror selfie. Mirror selfie. Shirtless mirror selfie. Sophie. There's a lot of Sophie in here. I didn't get the impression they were close. Oh my god.
Oh?
Wow, that is really close. Who even were you, Sophie?
Damn.
I really thought I could help. Poke around a little, figure out who has it out for Sophie. Bada bing, bada boom. Case solved, right? Why else would my powers come back? Stupid. Now I have more impossible questions than I had to begin with. Lucas filing a restraining order? Vin and Sophie sleeping together? Gwen killing Sophie's book deal? I have no idea what any of it means.
Yeah, I'm pretty confused.
And the worst part is, I can't even talk to you about any of it. I won't be able to save you. Again. Whatever I do, it's going to turn out worse than I could even imagine.
Get the fuck off me! I can't breathe!
What, he fall through the thin ice?
Everyone stay back. Give him some space. He's having a panic attack or something.
I'm not fucking crazy. I know what I saw up there.
Hey, looky-loos, fuck off already.
Can you run and get him some water? You okay, Reggie?
Am I okay? Fuck. After what I just saw up there.
Reggie, up where?
The fucking overlook. Yes, I know. I shouldn't have been up there. I'm a fucking idiot.
It's okay. I'm not mad. I just want to know what you were doing up there.
Remember in your seminar how you said we should take photos of things that scare us?
Well, A plus for following directions, then. Now, you want to tell me what you saw?
I saw myself. Another me. Walking around. Working on the puzzle box, the one that I gave you earlier.
What did this other you want?
I wasn't gonna fucking talk to him. I fucking ran, Max.
Did you tell anyone what you saw? Did you tell... Loretta, thank you. Can you take Reggie to the infirmary?
Sure thing, Miss Caulfield. I'll see you later, yeah?
Just make sure he's all right.
Thanks, Max.
So it's blending. Interesting. So it's not just her. She's blending both realities.
Time to go back up there. I can handle this. He's not just gonna let me by, is he? Better start heading up to the overlook. Hope there's a place to cross back over on the way. This looks a lot like Sophie's favorite candy.
This goes against everything I learned in horror movies, but I should check for more weird shit.
Kind of curious to see where this story is going.
Be right back. Oh, shit. I have some good news. It's big, but I can't tell you what it is.
Why am I not at home wrapped up in a blanket burrito right now?
All right, Max. You have 24 hours before the world ends. What would you do?
The bigger the art project, the more of the path it blocks when it falls. From here, I should be able to make it up to the overlook.
I wonder if I should go back down and see if there's anything down there.
The vibes here are way off. I should look into why.
Yeah, there's nothing down here.
Hello?
Hello? This is Sophie. Yes, this is Sophie. Hiya.
Speaking.
Shit!
She had a panic attack. Any more unexplainable things the universe would like to throw at me today?
last time I saw this Gwen, she was being escorted out of the building.
Trying to avoid me, Max?
Trying not to bother you, actually.
Oh, take a joint. What the fuck?
Thanks.
Careful there, Pineapple Express.
Right.
Shit.
Right.
Did pot get stronger since I was in school?
Before I came out, I had this boss, free thinker, who adopted his worldview wholesale from shouty YouTubers.
Yikes.
And a raging transphobe to boot. They're brainwashing our kids, blah, blah, blah. And of course, I was afraid if I said something, said anything, he'd figure me out. But when I was alone, I could conjure the perfect soliloquy to shut him up. Make him feel as small as he made me.
Isn't there, like, a special word for that? In French, right?
L'esprit de l'escalier. The wit of the stick. I take it you're acquainted.
Oh, yeah. That one's a Max Caulfield greatest tip.
Point is, I've always been able to think of something to say eventually. But what do you say about something like that?
Gwen, what is this?
Video proof. Allegedly. Trafficking of a controlled substance on campus.
Hold on.
Bruh.
There's no way Yasmin thinks you were selling drugs.
How could she not? That there is security footage of someone who looks like me, dealing to students.
Someone who looks like you? This is such bullshit. Can't you fight it?
Fight it? How? That wasn't me, it was my evil twin.
Yo.
No. No. Fuck it. They've already made up their mind.
You don't mean that.
I wonder if it was her other self.
Thanks for believing in me, Max, but I'm sick of fighting to prove I deserve to be here.
Lucas shouting at his son? Reggie seeing himself here in the other timeline? Is Gwen another victim of doppelganger-itis? Or is she just trying to cover her ass? If I could look at that footage, maybe I could figure it out.
Gwen? What are you doing?
Saying goodbye. And fuck you! Caledon, to Yasmin, and to feeling powerless. Gotta take catharsis where you can get it.
Save it.
What the fuck?
Gwen, listen. If I can just get a look at this footage, I might be able to help.
I didn't ask for your help, Max. Jesus, I didn't even ask for your company. I just wanted to get stoned and watch that thing burn. Whatever. Do what you want. It's too cold for this shit.
Quinn, wait. I need to ask you something. Why did you kill Sophie's book deal?
Were you going through my computer?
What? No, she told me, but not why.
Jesus.
Now, let's see if I can find what Reggie saw, or thinks he saw. What would you think of all this, Hannah? Would you still be inspired?
Favorite spot of the late artist Hannah Hellerton, the daughter of Kaladin alumnus and media mogul James Hellerton, who died tragically at 21. She often came here to think and be inspired. Gwen's tires?
Jesus, fuck! You've got to be kidding me.
Do you think it was a student who didn't like their final grade?
I doubt it. Usually those kinds tip me off with an angry, poorly written email.
Oh, Loretta.
Do you know who did do this?
No.
Jesus. Why does it feel like Gwen's all?
I get why Gwen would come up here. It's amazing how peaceful this place feels.
Your power is changing everything, especially you.
Something bad is happening here.
Even after everything I saw on the path, I can't explain any of it.
Something strange is happening. And it feels like it has everything to do with my powers. I feel like I'm in a room with 100 doors. And I don't know what's behind any of them.
But it's nice to stand here for a while and not choose.
If I tamper with it, the cops will know. Might be another way. See something, say something, right? I swear, if these owls could talk. If I cross over, I can try to see what Reggie saw up here.
What?
Fuck! Oh!
Oh, Miss Caulfield, you, out for a stroll too?
Something like that. By the way, I appreciated your help with Reggie.
Oh, that? It was the least I could do. Reggie's a sweetheart.
Holy shit, what are those? You can see those?
Yeah. Do you think this is what Reggie saw?
That's not really mine to share.
I'm not trying to... I just want to make sure he's okay. Honest.
He will be. I think.
I was gonna come up here anyway after the suicide tip, but... seeing Reggie like that... I don't know. Made it feel... real.
Wait. Suicide tip?
One of the B cops let it slip. You run a successful podcast for a few years and you find ways to get people to open up.
Right.
Speaking of opening up, I got a lead. I could cut you in.
One second I'm a source, and the next I'm a fellow investigator? Sounds like there's strings attached.
No, it's not like that. I feel like I kind of owe you after the whole Dr. Hunter thing.
Right.
Maya Okada, one of Safi's classmates during undergrad.
Mm-hmm.
They were friends. Then, Maya died a couple years back. Suicide, apparently.
You think it's a pattern?
Maybe, yeah. Two promising young writers, both dead, both by their own hand, according to official sources.
But Safi didn't kill herself.
Like I said, a pattern. Maybe.
Explain something to me. Why is this so important to you? Safi was my friend.
Because I hate it when things don't make sense.
God damn, who's blowing me up? Moses?
I have to go.
Huh.
Got your text. Tried calling, but you didn't pick up.
It's cool, Max. Everything's cool.
It's not cool, though.
It is not.
Right.
So what's the damage?
TLDR version? Pretty sure I'm the number one suspect.
What? Why?
Besides that being true for most of my life?
Yeah, shocking, right?
Well, I did.
I wonder if it's because... Oh, motherfucker, what'd you do?
I took Sophie's camera.
Her camera?
I know.
Yeah.
Moses, why did you...
It wasn't like a rational decision. I wasn't thinking. When we found her that night, I saw the camera. And I thought the last picture she took in her life was that selfie of the three of us. And Sophie would never want to have that camera, that picture, in the hands of the fucking police.
Real. I get it.
So I brought it back to my office. And then I realized, what the fuck am I doing? That's evidence in a murder case. So I just hid it in there. In my office.
Moses!
I screwed up. Now, I don't know what to do.
All right. Maintenance tech is on his way to unlock your office, Mr. Murphy. Then I'll just have a look around inside.
Shit! I've got to get Sophie's camera out of there. Somehow.
Unless you have a key card. Miss Coffee.
Yeah, and you are...
Sorry, I don't think we've been introduced. Mr...
That's Detective. Detective Vince Alderman with Vermont State Police. I'll be handling your friend Sophia's case from now on. I'm sorry for your loss, by the way.
Moses and I already spoke to police. Several times.
Max, it's okay.
And I'll be speaking to Mr. Murphy quite a bit more today. Miss Caulfield, I do need you to leave the area for the time being.
Will you be okay?
Mr. Murphy will be fine.
I'll come back. Promise.
Okay. Now's my chance to get into Moses' office. Where's a place I can shift to the other timeline? Wow, these are heavy duty. I can't see anything through them. Is all this going to change now that Alderman's on the case? These open into Moses' office, I think. Maybe I can find a way into Moses' office from this side. Hey, maybe this Moses can help me find the camera.
Damn, this is a big-ass office, bro. Jesus
hey, Max.
Christ.
Man, that's annoying. How do you stand
hey,
it?
Hey, hot dog man.
You'd be surprised how quickly you get used to it.
I think they call that Stockholm Syndrome.
Yeah.
So, what's up?
Actually, I need to ask you kind of a weird question.
My favorite kind. Name it.
Left field, but if you were gonna hide something personal in this lab, where would you put it?
If this is about my dream diary, trust me, you'll never find it. I'd never bring it to campus.
You never told me you keep a dream diary.
And I never will. Pure conjecture on your part.
Right.
What is your most prized possession? In here, at least.
In here? But probably that mug. My sister made it for me as an early Christmas gift.
Oh. That's sweet.
Remind me not to get you any mugs for Christmas.
Okay. Name something in here you wouldn't want, say, Dr. Faya to find.
Like, something I keep locked away?
Yes. Yes, exactly.
That would definitely be my electric kettle. Maintenance has no idea where I hide that fire hazard.
As I live and breathe. Moses Murphy. Rule breaker.
Rule bender, Max. Rule bender. Anyway, what's with all the questions? Oh.
Ooh.
Moses. Need me to hold something, or can I help somehow?
Actually, yeah. I need an Allen wrench.
On it. Got one around here?
No, I borrowed one from Carla, but I think she took it back. If you can go grab that from her, I'll owe you.
Right.
Okay. I can't go looking around for Carla. I need a faster way to get in. I can't get over how busy everyone is in this timeline. Mm-hmm. Did I forget what normal life is like?
Hi, Moses. Stole my Allen wrench set back last night. I hope that's cool. Some of my freshmen needed help with their robotics final, and I couldn't keep the fans waiting. Hit me up if you still need them, Carla.
This is pretty impressive. A lot more complicated than I would have thought. I bet Moses knows something interesting about every one of these stars. Where do you keep your kettle?
Hang on, Max. I gotta adjust my grip.
I feel like I understand this now. Maybe I've gotten smarter with age.
Named after the famous Schrodinger thought experiment, a cat state is a quantum superposition composed of two opposite states existing at the same time, such as an atom being at once both decayed and not decayed. Attempting to measure a particle in a cat state will cause it to collapse to an Eigen state, thus leaving superposition. This is known as the measurement problem, Schrodinger's equation. Huh.
Moses was so excited when this came out. I think he bought 7 copies.
Pioneering Kaladin's astrophysics department. Hey, photo by Max Caulfield.
The wonders of modern technology have rendered us a turtle with a gun. Worth it.
Harold's dishes. I've heard so many jokes about this mysterious office mate that I don't know what's true anymore.
There's no way Yasmin would be okay with how Alderman is treating him. Moses is her prodigy. Aw, Maggie's cute. They're all cute, really.
Wishing you and your family all the best this holiday season. With love, the Murphys.
Moses said living on his own for the first time was harder than the astrophysics. Yeah, this is why I'm not a physicist. Knowing at least one Moses gets a happy Christmas.
That's still annoying.
That makes me feel better or worse. God, I bet every sad poem she ever wrote is being used to justify the suicide angle.
She rattles chains, drags her fingernails along the wall. The houses of men are built on the bones of unnamed women. Whenever he speaks, I hear only an unearthly moaning coming from underground. The flowers on her grave wither and are replaced.
Just need to get Moses that wrench.
Everybody loves a dead girl better than a live one. A dead girl doesn't age, doesn't argue, doesn't claim ownership of what is hers. She owns nothing but the dirt and the clothes they put her in. That last part though? Hey, what's up, Dead Poet? Dead Poets Kid, are you a fan of Dead Poets Society? That's one of my favorite fucking movies.
So this is how you set up the infamous depressed chess.
I can see why this character is Moses' favorite. He's always looking up. Moses might actually hate snack residue on his fingers more than he hates scientifically inaccurate movies.
Fair.
Love this cozy little donut corner. I thought I'd never hear another dirty joke about this thing. But Sophie's alive here. I need to get that Allen wrench, and I need to be quick. If the tea kettle was a fire hazard, I guess a heat lamp is out of the question.
Oh, Moses. What a horrible reminder.
My birthday gift to Moses. I could tell how badly he wanted to say, but the moon doesn't emit its own light.
I remember her wearing this earlier that night.
It's funny because I never actually, like, thought about it. Like, I'm like, yeah, like, it doesn't, but I've, like, never thought about how the stars reflect the light off the moon. It's just not a thought I've had.
Maybe the wrench is near Moses' equipment.
Aha.
Better give this wrench to Moses. This must have been dropped off while Moses was out.
Oh, I got so scared because I was like, okay, what if the...
Oh, to be a tiny plant in a vial, protected by a team of high-tech androids. Aw, Maggie's cute. They're all cute, really.
Yeah, the Christmas card is still there.
It hurts to look at this.
What? Bitch, you did not just...
Relax. It was a picture of the mugs you two were drinking out of.
Good. Oh, I would rather murder all my students with my bare hands than grade one more final.
Real. No. Were you two up all night?
Probably what I'll say in the future.
And I'll be working on these astronomy finals until sundown.
Real as fuck.
What? On a good day, that 3D printer would be making all kinds of cool stuff. But today's not...
Moses was so excited when this came out. I think he bought 7 copies.
This must be for working on the mural.
Oh, what the fuck?
Did Moses draw this? This is beautiful. It'd be better from another angle.
Yep, up top. I was thinking the same thing, baby.
Better give this wrench to Moses. For astronomers who hate the outdoors.
Real as fuck.
Moses and Sophie. So different, and yet so well suited.
Why is that still in the picture? Well, that's the best I can do. Alright, give him the Allen wrench, find out the missing... I'm kind of surprised how long the chapters are. It feels a lot longer than normal.
Better give this wrench to Moses.
So I found this guy named Allen, but he didn't know anything about a wrench.
No, this bitch. Not literally, Alan. It's...
Bruh.
Oh.
He fell for that shit.
You're a lifesaver, Max.
Come on now.
Dad joke aside.
I'll never apologize for my dad jokes. And you're welcome. The mural goes here. What's that about?
Sophie's baby. She had the bright idea that we should draw the Gemini twins up there.
I didn't know you had an artistic side.
Long dormant. Comes with being the only scientist in a family of artsy-fartsy types.
Right.
Anyway, I'm sure we'll get to it at some point. We have all the time in the world. So, did you want some tea?
Yeah, if you don't mind. With the contraband kettle, right?
Okay. Oh, bitch, there's a key.
Just give me just a second.
Sure.
All I need is a
second. So the cabinet is a secret hiding spot. Let's hope the other noses hid the camera in the same place. Oh my god, stop! I bet Moses covered his bedroom with bees as a kid.
Bruh.
Damn.
What?
This note wasn't here in the other timeline. That can't be a coincidence. Is this where he hid Sophie's camera?
How long does it take to bring a damn key?
Under safe? Don't leave the note out like that.
The camera might be under a safe. Where can I find this safe?
Safe.
The maker of this mug sure knows her target audience.
Maybe up top? I didn't really see, I mean, I guess in a bookshelf?
I don't remember ever seeing an actual safe in this office.
I don't know, it might have to be the question for him. Because I have no idea.
Maybe the safe is hidden somewhere.
Will it distract you if I talk?
She'll be fine. What's up?
So, the mural. What's the story there?
I made the mistake of telling Safi I used to want to be a comic book artist, as she found a project that would force me to draw. We're going to use my star projector to trace the constellation and then draw the twins around it.
And Gemini, what's the significance?
Really, I chose it because there are two of us and we'd be working on it together. But Safi imbued it with meaning, the scientist and the poet. Duality. She sells it better than me.
Okay, nothing safe.
That telescope, how long have you been working on it?
A couple days. Why?
Is there anything special about it?
A better question would be, what isn't special about it? Misunderstood in its heyday, due in part to its experimental lens design, it's only now being lauded as the revelation it is.
Underestimated and later appreciated. May we all be so lucky. Another strange question. You don't have a safe in here, do you?
The locking kind? No.
Are there non-locking safes?
Well, for a second, I thought you were asking about the star safe. S-A-I-P-H.
There's a star called Safe.
Sure is. It's a part of the Orion constellation.
Huh.
What the?
Popcorn.
You've been popcorned.
Right.
Engineering wants a prank war. I'm trying not to sink to their level. Gonna go clean this up.
So Moses hid the camera under a star. And of course, there are stars everywhere.
Why is it so happy?
And they're safe on the lower left.
Oh, so we use the star projector and then we'll find it. So lower left.
The mural. Moses must have projected some stars to use as a guide. Moses said SAFE is part of Orion. Maybe Orion was projected on the wall that night. I need to set this up exactly how Moses had it when he was drawing.
Like that, right?
I think I got it.
The bottom left.
Fingers crossed I can find SAFE on that wall.
Damn, this has become such like an intricate puzzle.
So if this is Orion, then SAFE is... Boom. Good job finding SAFE, Max. Why, thank you, Max. Now then.
Oh, the vent.
No, no, no!
Right.
Shit, I can't let him see me in here. I'm so close to getting Safi's camera. If I can just distract him for a few minutes, I think I can grab it. I'll need something noisy.
Well, I know what'll do that. Noisiest thing in here.
Good thing I can keep an eye on Alderman from here. Wouldn't want to show up right in front of him.
I can't leave here without Safi's camera.
Upstairs, maybe?
I need to make sure Alderman won't see me when I Here goes.
What the hell?
And now I need to shift out of here fast. Time to finally get what I came here for in the first place.
Hey! Is someone down there?
Stupid telescope! Why couldn't Moses have put you together in this timeline?
What? Can I move objects into different timelines?
What the actual fuck?
That's new. Yes!
What the fuck?
Holy shit. The telescope and all the parts switched places.
Huh.
Gotta run. Sorry, I'll text you.
Yo. What?
That's kind of wild, actually. Okay, cool. So everything still stays the same. It's just the object itself.
Moses.
Caulfield, I speak with you for a minute.
You should go.
Please, have a seat. I just wanted you to have a chance to talk to me alone. Because Miss Llewellyn was a close friend of yours. We have a sensitive situation. We know Miss Llewellyn's camera was taken by someone closely linked to her death. Now, I'm pretty certain I know who took it and why. Maybe you've even guessed my thinking. If we're going to make any progress on your friend's case, that's not enough. Therefore, I'm asking you if you have or come by any information about this person or where they've taken the camera, can I trust you to let me know? Miss Caulfield.
Sure. Of course. If I notice anything, I'll let you know.
I'm glad to hear it. And I'm sure Dr. Fayed would be grateful as well. Now that is my direct number. No detail is too small to share. You're not bothering me. You're helping your friend's case. Thanks again for your time, Miss Caulfield. Have a good day.
Alright, that gets him off our back.
Moses, I want to show you something.
We don't have to talk about.
Look.
Okay. We're good.
Okay. Let's download Safi's photos onto your computer, yeah? Or...
You go ahead. I need a minute to get my thoughts in order. I'll join you soon.
Okay.
Wait, is that...
Wilder Beasts Than These by Lucas Colmenero?
Figures there'd be cut. Might as well add it to my collection of so-called clues. I picked up so many things today. Best lay it all out and see if it gets me anywhere.
Now it's being choppy on... Why is it being so choppy on stream now? Let me exit out. I'm trying to get it to... Okay, it looks like that's back in order. Let me see if I can get it. Still choppy, choppy. What? Why? Literally all of a sudden. That's so fucking stupid. It this way. I'm just trying to see if I can get it to go real quick. Okay. There. It just needed... Oh.
Okay. Let's download Safi's photos onto your computer.
Spoke too soon.
Get my thoughts in order.
Okay. Whatever. Whatever, dude. I'll take that as a sign, honestly. Anyway, that's a good time to stop it anyway, because goddamn, this chapter is so long. Jesus. I'm curious. All chapters at once. Five chapters also, and double exposure. All right. Well, that's actually perfect. It's 10 hours exactly. I wanted to try and just... I bet you this is the end of the chapter, too. Fuck it. Let's see if I restart it, if it'll fix itself. That's really fucking annoying that out of nowhere it's just lagging on the stream. Because I'd rather finish the stream at the end of the chapter.
They tap at the windows and think they were bones. Lay hands on the
floor. All right, that part's promising. Now let's see.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's download Sophie's photos onto your computer, yeah?
Alright. I'm just trying to get to the end of the second chapter before I close it out.
You go ahead. I need a minute to get my thoughts in order. I'll join you soon.
Okay.
Wait, is that Wilder Beasts Than These by Lucas Colmenero? Figures there'd be copies all over camp. Might as well add it to my collection of so-called clues. I picked up so many things today. Best lay it all out and see if it gets me anywhere. Can't say it was the brightest idea, especially for an astrophysicist, but I am glad Moses got Sophie's camera.
Oh, hey.
Is that a compartment? Does something come out of here? I too like to strip naked with my friends and dance under the all-seeing eye to demonstrate my commitment to society. Hey, can I move those pegs? I need a bit of space to examine the clues I've gathered.
Shit, I don't know.
I bet the coffee table has enough room for my evidence. That's definitely a compartment. But I can't get it open yet. The first puzzle box tested my eye for detail. This one must test another Abraxas value.
God, Max, how many of these movies are there?
It's a horror franchise, Sophie. They don't get good until at least the third one.
The real horror is that they found a way to make three of these. Five, actually.
So, is this the...
Oh, wow. I guess I haven't been home in this world for a couple days. It's like a time capsule of the day Sophie died. Weird.
I should crack those open eventually. Sophie's alive here, and she might ask me what I thought.
I loved telling Sophie how the lens can totally change your perception of a subject. I loved that she didn't need me to explain why that was powerful.
We took in a little liquid courage before the bowling alley shoot. Sophie's insistence, well, mostly Sophie's.
Hmm.
Moses is waiting for me in the other, world. My dark room here is empty. It's been a minute since I exhibited in a gallery, but Dr. Preston was excited about working together on something next year. With Safi alive in this timeline, I don't even know what to put here, if anything.
Oh, there we go.
If there's a silver lining, it's that I've got another chance to take a proper candid of you.
Okay.
Can I just say, as a Virgo, I do not feel kind, industrious, or perfect these days.
Alright. I need to see what's on the cube. Okay. Let's go with polygon shape. There's 3, 4, 5.
I need a bit of space to examine the clues I've gathered. Can I just say, as a Virgo, I do not feel kind, industrious, or perfect these days.
3, 4, 5, 6, with 3 going out.
I bet the coffee table has enough room for my evidence.
Sigma-ish. Damn. Well, because I want to do it. Oh, well, if he's waiting for me, I wonder if it would be fine, actually.
I can't remember when it's been this clean, but it'd be the perfect place to put all my, Okay, Max. Let's see what we've got.
It might be okay, because
this was meant to be a loud message, but from who? And what does it mean? While I do want to see this so-called incriminating footage of Gwen, it's probably best to wait till I know Vin and Abraxas are entangled in everything that's happening. Lucas, I really don't think he's the one who smashed Sophie's windshield, but there's clearly more bad blood here than I knew about. I still don't understand why Gwen would do this to Safi. Especially since she helped her get the book deal in the first place. I probably shouldn't leave all this out in the open. Maybe if I step away for a bit, these will all make sense later. Hope Moses is doing all right. I should go see if he's gotten Safi's camera hooked up yet.
also Sigma type.
Can I just say, as a Virgo,
there's no Sigma.
I do not feel kind, no. Industrious, or perfect.
Oh,
these
maybe
days.
That's it. That's the only thing you can kind of see. I don't know. I'm kind of stumped for that. But I want to solve it before going any further, because I probably will miss it.
This side's telling me nothing. That's definitely a compartment, but I can't get it open yet. I really want to see what Sophie captured on her camera. Moses said he was getting set up in the dark room.
Yes!
Hey, something just happened. It sounded like a panel popped open. A disc with some symbols. Well, well, well. Max Caulfield, you clever minx. Wait, does the outer dial move now? It does. And so does the inner one.
That was random as fuck.
This means I'm in, right?
Abraxas Society.
I am official Abraxas material?
There we go. Fucking A. I thought that was gonna take me forever. Alright, now let's do this. Kinda curious to see if she has anything on her camera that's gonna be like, what the fuck kind of idea. Oh, it's a dark room basement.
Moses? You okay?
Is it weird that I'm low-key nervous about seeing Safi's, you know, final pictures?
Far from it. Safi was special to us. To everyone. But I meant, are you okay, okay?
Been better.
I apologize for what I said to that detective. You have to know I wasn't being serious. I was only trying to
take the easy way. It's nice when you have that option.
It's not that, bro. I'm just trying to get him off our back.
It's fine. It's fine.
Hey, look. Maybe seeing Sophie again will help clear the air. Hard to believe that would be the last time we were all together.
That's the truth.
What a crew we were.
Hey, look. She took one more photo.
Sneaky girl. What is this?
What?
Max, you... You killed her?
What? No! Of course not!
So that... That...
It's Photoshop! A deepfake, maybe. I don't know.
You sold me out to Alderman. You were covering for yourself.
No, Moses. Please. Let me explain. Try to.
Well?
I have these powers. Time powers. And somehow Safi's death is related to those powers. Wait! I can prove it to you.
You stay the fuck away from me.
Shit. Yo, what did Safi do in the other timeline? Damn. Wow, most people deleted the photo. Save the footage. Lucas appreciates the chance to handle Safi on his own. Gwen feels betrayed. Alderman's pleased you cooperated. Oh, most people refuse. I just agreed to get him off our fucking back, okay? A lot of people didn't help him. Confident, yeah. Did not reflect. Oh, shit, you could reflect in the North Quad, I didn't know. Did not sign up. I didn't know you could. God damn it. Max stood by her comments to Lucas at Safi's memorial. Admitted to Lucas that she felt confused. No. Yep, double horns. Kept it professional. Okay. Oh, shit. That's right. I forgot to leave the cards. Crack the code on her own. Yeah, fuck Loretta. Took the joint. Wow, a lot of people missed the overlook. Max told Loretta what Reggie saw was none of her business. Real. Alright. Well, that's a good place to stop. I have no idea where this is going, so I'm excited. But I have a feeling, my theory is that Max told Safi to take that photo for this timeline, because it's not like they're evil twins or something, it's the same person. So, I have a feeling Max has to frame herself in this universe, or in this reality, because it might have been somebody she actually, needs to save. Gwen gets framed for it, and she's like, nah, I gotta, the only way to save Gwen is by creating actual evidence for myself or something. I don't know. But I'm excited to figure this out. I can't tell you when I'm gonna stream again. It might be tomorrow, it might be another day, but I'm happy we at least got the game working, so that way we could, finish off the chapter clean. If you're watching on Twitch, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. If you're watching on YouTube, I hope you're just as excited as I am for the next episode and we can go through it. I think Life is Strange, I will upload episode by episode versus as a full stream, so episode 1 and 2 will be separate. 3, 4, and 5 will be separate. And then I'll upload the finale of Silent Hill right after this also. So, yeah. If you're here, thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time. Deuces.